The business community has been behind Malacanang's anti-corruption drive since day one, but it wants the president to lay down a clear direction for the economy, including the passage of pending economic bills to sustain the country's gains. It also wants government to start bidding out public-private partnership projects that have long been delayed. Now, here to tell us the business community's wish list for the SONA is Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry President, Attorney Miguel Varela. Good morning, sir. Thank you very
good
much.
Good morning. Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing great, but before I ask you about your wish list, I want to ask you first, of course, customary for you to grade the president, how he did the past year. How did he do?
Well, he did well. Mm-hmm. At least he has given more confidence to government and the economy and the country's image as an investment destination.
Mm-hmm. But how did he do that? Is it just from his the programs that the government initiated?
Yes, I think so. There were programs that they have discussed in the cabinet to be able to achieve this, no?
Mm-hmm.
And also they are working with the private sector. No, mm-hmm. It's very important also that they should be working with the private sector, because the private sector can also help, especially in investment promotion, no?
Mm-hmm.
And giving better image for the country as an investment destination.
Mm-hmm.
Very important at this time, because we need more foreign direct investments.
Mm-hmm.
We're lacking, and and we are far from our other ASEAN countries.
Pero under his administration ba, sir, medyo dumami nga talaga yung pumapasok na foreign investments?
Oo, kasi nakaroon na more inspiration, no? His policy on strong, forceful advocacy of good governance,
mm.
that is transparent,
mm.
that is accountable, and people-oriented, is really a milestone. It has created a lot of inspiration both from local and foreign investors, because they see that they have better opportunities, there is a level playing field that is assured.
Mm.
And there are efforts now by the government and the various agencies to improve the bureaucracy.
Mm.
And this is really happening.
Mm-hmm.
As a matter of fact, we in the PCCI is working very closely with them in some of these, no? Especially in the issuance of permits, mm. licenses, and so on, and investment promotion as well. No?
Mm-hmm.
We have our own tie-ups and contacts from various counterpart chambers, foreign chambers, globally.
Right, right. Of course, of course. But some may say na baka nakadagdag lang doon is medyo sinwerte lang din ng Pilipinas. Di lang din naman si President Aquino. At a time that the economy of the United States
down.
And of course the euro crisis are down, and investors are looking at Asia.
Mm-hmm.
Pero laking tulong na rin na sinasabi nyo kanina was the President is doing something about it.
Kasi
it's not just
talagang pinilit niya, no? Pinilit niya yung good governance niya, at saka linisin yung bureaucracy.
Mm-hmm.
Of course,
mm-hmm.
there are still a lot of things to be done in the bureaucracy, but at least he has set the tone and he has started the work, no?
Mm-hmm.
And which has produced very good results, because confidence in the government, as I said, is there, and in the economy,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
as recent.
And we were talking off camera a while ago, we're pretty certain that 6.4 GDP in the first quarter is gonna be part of the SONA.
The best, the
best. Kasi yun yung pinakamalaking numero pwede niya pagyabang eh.
2012, first quarter of 2012,
But would that be enough? I mean, how about the other numbers? The unemployment rate, slight dip?
Well, alam mo, nung tumas yung ating GDP growth to 6.4, naka-create ng more than a million employment.
Mm-hmm.
There was followed up from this increase in the GDP is employment.
Mm-hmm.
There was employment opportunities, especially in the service sector and also in industry. So, as you're saying, if we have if our growth continues and is sustained, we will be able to attract more investors because there are other factors that we should really look into. No, you know, upgrade natin. We have been continuously getting better upgrades. So malapit na tayo sa investment grade. It's very possible that it will come. Yeah. Diba? Nandiyan yung stock exchange index.
Hitting record highs.
That's right. Yes, yes, yes. 15.8%, I understand. And this is one of the, they say, one of the 10 best performing stock markets globally.
Right, right, right.
Oh, nandiyan din yung, ano natin, yung, there was, ano, there was, a big saving surplus in the budget that was used to cover up for budget deficit. Yung surplus yata sa budget, more than 3 billion, that's something, no? Last 4 months. Your revenues natin have increased by more than 11%. Yun dahil sa siguro ano ng gobyerno, intensive campaign against tax evaders, di ba? Yung foreign reserves natin, record high, 77 billion. Kaya nakapagpautang tuloy tayo sa
IMF. Diba? Nakapagpalagay na tayo
ng pondo. So, yung government is now spending more. Di ba? Nakakapag-step up ng mga infrastructure projects.
Speaking of infrastructure projects, yes, comparatively, the government is spending more as opposed to last year when they said that they were ironing out all of the agreements. And now that they have ironed out some of them, they're spending more. But are they doing enough? It's already July, way past, half of the year already.
I understand.
Have they been doing enough?
I understand from the report of the Public Works and Highways, 85% is already out and already ongoing. 85% of the contracts, public work contracts, are already ongoing, no? And they're asking now for a bigger budget. Actually, the budget for next year is two trillion.
Yes,
so.
Yes.
And this means that bigger allocation for infrastructure. That will be, it means new infrastructure can be developed. That is really what we need, new infrastructures. We have to do this in order for us to be able to attract investors. It's the investors that will create and give us opportunities to create more jobs and help our countrymen.
Is the president doing enough to attract those investors?
The DTI is doing their jobs very effectively. More promotion, strategies to invite investors. That's very good. That is why we are working very closely with the DTI. We have our own efforts. We have organized business councils that is focused on trade. So this is to complement the efforts of the DTI, who's doing a very good job in promotion of investments.
You mentioned a while ago that, of course, even with the achievements and successes of the president, there will always be something that's lacking.
Yes.
For President Aquino and his administration, ano pa ba yung kulang dun sa mga ginagawa?
Well, siguro kailangan fast track pa lalo yung mga other projects, yung mga bidding, no? Yung bidding should be fast track because this will encourage investors, no? Kasi pag delay yan, mawala yung ating competitiveness, no, as an investment destination. So it should be fast track. And then there are other measures that should be done. Some legislation should really be passed in order to create a better atmosphere and better environment of investment in the country, so attract more investors.
Wait, are you talking about charter change?
Well,
charter change yung pinag-uusapan natin.
No, actually no. I never had that in mind.
But we have the heads of the chambers of Congress, of course. Congressman, the House Speaker,
Wrong with charter change as long as they say, they should be confined to economic changes. Although, I think that's difficult to happen, no? But If they say so, you have to give them the
benefit of the doubt.
Benefit of the doubt. Mm. However, if they cannot do this at this time, when there is, because there is no hurry, as the president also said, they can also already pass legislations that will boost the economy. Mm-hmm. Legislation can in the meantime be made to strengthen the economy.
So you agree with the president that it shouldn't be a priority right now?
Well,
through legislation,
it might
life, it's going to be.
I don't know. Maybe they could define the parameters on how they will approach this. They can present a program on how they will do it with the timelines. No, because if it will be left, it might create some problems, and it might occupy much of their time, and forgetting the more important legislations. We don't want to lose opportunities right now. We have the momentum for growth. Our country, the president has brought the country into almost in a competitive level with ASEAN. So let's move on. Let's continue. Let us pursue this. And in all the branches of government must be assisting. No?
Okay, let's go to businesses now. You're saying that yes, there are a lot of achievements by this this administration, that the economy is doing better. Are the businesses feeling it?
Well,
most importantly, are the employees feeling it? Not just
the
employers.
Of course, there is no satisfaction or total contentment for everybody. You know, in business, really, the cost of doing business is very high. You know, you know, power rates is the main culprit, no? The cost of transport and logistics is also very high, no? It's also very high. And we have inefficient, inefficient ports, no? Ports that really cannot really accommodate big ships, big airplanes, so on. They lack equipment, they lack facilities, no connections to the main networks, mm-hmm, no? Mm-hmm. These things are there, no? So that I think we should really take a look on how we can be able to respond to this, no? You need more. Not only the government was together with all the branches of government work together, but also with the private sector. Government must work in tandem with the private sector, preparing, creating roadmaps to address problems like high cost of power and rest, high cost of transport and other logistics, an industry plan, competitiveness program for industry, so that it can be a more vibrant sector. No? Mm-hmm. Things like this, no? Should really be undertaken. So the president has done a lot, but there are still things to be done.
Right, and there are a lot of other things that you want to talk about, about what the president can still do. But for today, Sona, I'm going to jump off from our question of the day posted by ANC Alerts on Twitter. What would you want to hear from the president when he makes his State of the Nation address today?
Well, I mentioned some policy directions that will more or less define the country's viability for direct foreign investments, no? As well as the productivity and competitiveness of the local industries. How? By making power rates more competitive, by looking at the cost of transport and the logistics,
right,
by coming out with an industry plan that will strengthen the industry, create opportunity, a master plan that will create opportunities for products that has better chances in the global market, things like this. No, even probably population, because population growth pulls down the economy and contributes to poverty. So there are many things that these are some of the things that can be done and addressed too.
And I'm sure you're going to be listening intently to the president sooner or later. Attorney Miguel Varela of the PCC, I thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
The Ateneo Blue Eagles bounced back from their upset loss against the USC Growling Tigers last week. And the search for Michael Jackson's mom continues. Paolo has the latest in sports and entertainment when Mornings at ANC returns.
Yandro L. Mendoza, Cavite, 1st District, Joseph Emilio A. Abaya.